कभी कभी कोई ऐसी फिल्म आती है जिसको देखते हुए आपको ऐसा लगता है कि आपको किसी ने एक वॉशिंग मशीन में डाल दिया है एंड देर स्पिनिंग यू ओवर एंड ओवर एंड दे हैव सेट द सेटिंग टू डल, माइंड नमिंगली डल एंड यू जस्ट वॉन्ट टू एस्केप. दैट्स वॉट दिस फिल्म फील्स लाइक. हाई, एम प्रतीक्षा मिश्रा एंड यू आर लिसनिंग टू माई रिव्यू ऑफ बड़े मियाँ छोटे मियाँ. सबसे पहली बात, आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई वी हैड टू नेम दिस फिल्म दैट. आई गेट इट, आई गेट द फिल्म, द ओल्डर फिल्म का नॉस्टैल्जिया, बट द काइंड ऑफ निकनेम दीज टू पीपल, बड़े मियाँ एंड छोटे मियाँ, पीपल हु ऑलरेडी हैव निकनेम्स ऑफ फ्रेडी एंड रॉकी, उनके असली नाम अलग हैं. आई थिंक देर फिरोज एंड राकेश, इफ आई एम रिमेम्बरिंग राइट. निकनेम पे निकनेम, मे बी जस्ट टू जस्टिफाई द टाइटल, इट जस्ट आई डोंट नो, इट जस्ट डजंट मेक सेंस, बट नॉट अ लॉट मेक सेंस इन दिस फिल्म ईदर वे. The thing is, I have enjoyed this director's work before. I have liked films that Ali Abbas Zafar has made. For instance, Jogi, Bloody Daddy. I really enjoyed Bloody Daddy, especially the action sequences. They were just choreographed and crafted so well. But here, even the action isn't that up to the mark. I mean, it's okay, it's fine for an action film, but it's nothing to kind of write home about. I often say that I don't love action films as such. I mean, don't love is pushing it. It's not a genre that I choose for myself, but that also means that jab bhi maine koi action film dekhi hai, wo films hai jo bahut zyada popular hai, especially for their action sequences. So I get the thrill that you get from good action. And maybe that is why, after having watched so many films, I now also understand why mediocre action like this is just not working. That connect, that kind of tension just does not form. But even that you could have let go if just anything else was up to the mark. The action choreography and the cinematography also are just not going hand in hand. Un logon ka apna hi koi personal internal conflict chal raha hai, combat chal raha hai. That maybe would have been a better film to see, just the kind of rivalry between a cinematographer and an action director. Anyway, I digress. This film, let me give you some context first. Bade Miyan Chote Miyan is about two army captains jinka court martial kar diya gaya tha, Freddy and Rocky, played by Akshay Kumar and Tiger Shroff. On paper, these are roles jo ye dono hi actors kafi achhi tarike se nibhate. Kyunki is film mein ek achhi cheez ye hai ki the idea of a hero is a little bit shifted from what we've usually seen in action. They're not these kind of like constantly rowdy hyper masculine figures. They like to enjoy themselves, they like to have some fun. Tiger Shroff's character, for example, is often made fun of because of his horrible jokes. But ek baat hai, this gag would have been hilarious otherwise, but it's kind of feeling like it's making up for the fact that this film doesn't actually have any proper comedy of its own. Ek kharab joke likhne ke liye bhi, you need to have the skill. A joke has to be crafted in a way where the audience is aware that, wow, this is a bad joke because of how the character is written, not just because the person does not know how to write a joke. It just kind of comes off feeling as an excuse. The dialogues in general also are absolutely annoying, kyunki har character aapko scene mein kya ho raha hai bar bar bata raha hai. It's like watching those old episodes of CID jahan samne lash padi hoti hai aur char log aisa gol gol ghoom ghoom ke bolte rehte hain ki yahan lash padi hai, ye to mar gaya hai, ye ho gaya wo. That's what's happening throughout this film. For example, a tank is barreling towards a convoy and one person yells, "Oh, tank!" I'm sure people saw it. They're right there. We can see it. We're right here. And this is something that keeps going on. At some point, two characters tell you the same thing. This film takes tell, don't show and pushes it to the limit. This film could genuinely have been an audiobook and you wouldn't have missed anything. Akshay Kumar is a very good actor, especially when it comes to action sequences, but he also almost seems bored in the script because I feel like there's nothing novel that he's doing. All of this seems just natural to him, that he can just do in his sleep, and it feels like he's doing that. It's just one motion after the other. Tiger Shroff, as always, is great in the action sequences because he has that kind of movement to his body that always works in scenes like this. His acting has improved, I think, considerably from the last film of his that I saw, but still, considering the dialogues that they're given, they're all too corny to actually let anyone have much of an impact. There's also Manushi Chiller as Captain Misha, jinko Shanghai mein apne ek source se pata chalta hai ki ek war hone wala hai India pe, and also that the enemy that they're facing is actually a previously known friend. हमें स्टार्टिंग में पता चलता है कि इंडिया हैज डेवलप्ड दिस वेपन दैट नोबडी हैज सीन बिफोर. इट इज द बिगेस्ट वेपन एवर नोन एंड इट इज समथिंग दैट विल गिव अस अ ह्यूज एडवांटेज इन ऑल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स. और इस वेपन को एक कॉन्वॉय लेके जा रहा है, सिर्फ 5 गाड़ियां हैं उसमें बाय द वे, ये कॉन्वॉय लेके जा रहा है एंड समवन एम्बुशेस देम मिडिल में एंड टेक्स द वेपन विद देम. दिस मिस्टीरियस विलन, नाउ द एंटागोनिस्ट ऑफ दिस फिल्म, वेयर्स अ मास्क. नाउ हियर्स द थिंग, When the final reveal happens, you're wondering ki why wasn't this everyone's first guess? Not the audience, the characters. All the hints given only pointed to one person, and yet nobody was able to guess that this is the person that he's talking about. And that is another thing that happens in this film. A lot of times the plot holes are just too evident. And Rocky take a very guns first approach to everything. Diplomacy bari baat to chhodo, kahin koi baat hi nahi karta uski. Paperwork wagera never gets brought up, but they just blow everything up, finish their missions and come back. Everyone's patiently waiting for them to finish their mission also. Everyone else around them is stupid, but also they are not doing very smart things either. क्योंकि एंड में एक ऐसा सीन है जहां पे उनको एक बहुत ही हाई सीक्रेट पासवर्ड गेस करना है. हाउ डज द ऑडियंस गेस द पासवर्ड बिफोर यू? ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन इज देयर विथ देम एंड येट दे डोंट गेस द वेरी ऑब्वियस पासवर्ड. व्हेन यू वॉच द फिल्म यू विल रियलाइज दैट पासवर्ड वाज सो ऑब्वियस. इट वाज ऑलमोस्ट लाइक समवन कीपिंग देयर पासवर्ड एज पासवर्ड 123. दैट्स हाउ ऑब्वियस इट इज. One character that I did kind of enjoy was Alaya F's character. She is a professor in a university and is their kind of key to something that they want to open, a vault that they want to open to get the weapon back. Her character is this kind of bubbly, talkative, a little flirty nerd, essentially is what the film tags her as. And I like the way that character is written, because a lot of times we only get James Bond ke Q type ke characters ko hi dekhne ko milta hai, who's very serious, who's like tapping and solving all issues. But this is a fun kind of refreshing take on a character like that. And also, she seems very natural in this role. Ek bar jab Alaya F ka character film mein entry leta hai, to film mein thodi si jaan aa jaati hai. You're genuinely a little more intrigued by the film. I also really liked the way Prithviraj Sukumaran has played the villain. His dialogues also don't give him a lot to do, but just the kind of foreboding presence that he needs to have is done by the actor very well. So these two actors did impress me a lot by the performance. Sonakshi Sinha has a special appearance in this film. Unke bhi character ke paas zyada kuch karne ko hai nahi. Honestly, even I'm wondering ki is film mein koi kar kya raha tha. But let that be. Her character also gets a small part, but it's Sonakshi Sinha. Her performance is also what you would expect from her. It's good because she's a good actor, not because she's given a lot to do. But that doesn't mean that there's nothing about the film that I enjoyed. It's not completely unwatchable. I do think for a one-time watch, it's not that bad. There are parts of the film that work. Jaise ki ek jagah pe jo villain ka invention hai, there is some comment there about just mob mentality in general and how it's never good for society and how in the wrong hands it can actually be very, very dangerous. And I like that kind of commentary in a film like this. There's also the fact that kind of chest-humping jingoism that we've come to expect from films in this genre is absent from this film, and that, I hate to say it, is still a win at this point. Even the songs are nothing to kind of hum to or remember as such. The songs are fine when you're watching it on the big screen, but they're not memorable. Gaana dekhte waqt kafi mazedar hai, the choreography is also decent, the performers are also doing a decent job, but aapko theater chhod ke agar gaane ke bare mein kuch puchenge to I don't think you'll be able to remember much. This is also the kind of film that I don't know if it has a mass appeal, because kabhi kabhi aisi filmein hoti hai which might not be technically perfect, but for the mass appeal they work very, very well. I don't think this is a film that's kind of on that side of things either. If you're a fan of these like globe-trotting adventures, you might enjoy this film, because I enjoyed the scenes where we were seeing these massive kind of abroad locations. They were shot well also, and I just liked the scale of it. Other than this one desert scene, I did not understand what was happening there. I thought we were in a video game, but a badly produced one. But also, if you're someone who just likes watching movies for the fun of it, I guess you will enjoy it. I personally am looking for something more in my cinema, and that is why this film wasn't a 100% enjoyable experience for me. To be fair, whether the chemistry between the actors works or not, I did still enjoy the banter between Freddy and Rocky. Especially the one that happens because of the age gap between them. These are two people jinko saath mein bahut acche se kaam karna chahiye, but they're always at loggerheads. And that's just a fun kind of thing to see. I also like the way they just, even during combat scenes, are just being silly goofy. There's also the equation that they share with their supervisor Ronit Roy. Basically, Bade Miaan Chote Miaan would have still survived and it brought something new or something novel to the table, but it's not. It's everything that we've seen before. It might have been novel a few years ago, but now it's been done and dusted, especially with the volume of this kind of films that we've seen. If you want to watch Bade Miaan Chote Miaan, I would surely say go watch it. Tell me what you think. Personally, not a big fan, and that is why my rating for Bade Miaan Chote Miaan is 2 stars out of 5.